Hi folks, welcome to your MWIS Friday Planner in association with Ellis Brigham. Now it's a bitterly cold wind that's in existence into this weekend, and there's some further snow trying to edge its way in as well, but there's changes afoot in the weather pattern through the week ahead. Milder air is encroaching its way in, and a dramatic change in many respects for some places, with a distinct taste of spring in the air as we go through the week. It'll be a slow process to get that deeply cold air out of the highlands though, so that snowpack that's in existence will thaw only very slowly. Let's build the story then, and we'll begin with the freezing level chart. And first thing Saturday morning, it's what you're used to at the moment, which is extensively frozen terrain across the British Isles, and that will be the case through Saturday daytime. Still very cold air that's in existence across the country. And we just run this on as we go to Saturday evening and night. Not much changing there. Just notice the colours changing though toward the southwest as milder air associated with some fronts gets into Wales. And that process will continue for many places then as we head onwards into Sunday. Still essentially frozen terrain as we begin the day. And that terrain itself will stay broadly frozen across the hills throughout the day. But there is a lift of temperature moving in. Soonest and most marked across Wales. But everywhere likely to get that air temperature back above freezing as we go through the day. There will be some local complications though across the highlands in particular, where the deeply cold air just hangs in the valleys and the glens and will take quite a while for that to be scoured out basically by the milder air that's coming in. Some of the milder air just riding over the top of colder air that lies deep within the glens. As we take the story on into the start of next week, it's a generally milder one. Again, there may be a few local surprises in parts of the Highlands where the cold air and sub-zero conditions stay in existence even for a day or so early next week. So the freezing level, quite a difficult one to locally get the detail for in parts of the Highlands. But for many places, the temperatures tending to rise above freezing point to the higher mountain slopes. And this for the early days of next week. This is Monday. We'll just take the story on into Tuesday. It's a broadly milder situation. There may just be a time though around Tuesday into Wednesday where that freezing level is back to around 1,000 metres, perhaps even lower across the Highlands. So it's not at this stage dramatically mild air, but it's nowhere near as cold as we've seen in the past week. This is what that does to the snow depth, and this is the lying snow at any point in time in 6 hour time steps. Starting off first thing Saturday, you can see where the greatest extent is across Scotland and across the eastern side of the Pennines and the Borders. Just to take this on very quickly in the days ahead, there may be a bit of a top up briefly around Saturday into Sunday as fronts just come in, so some further snowfalls coming down. But then just as we take things on into next week, you'll see how the snow cover on the model chart just begins to ease back somewhat. This is onwards into Tuesday, still picking up some lying snow over the Pennines and still extensive depths across the eastern and southeastern parts of the Highlands. This through into Wednesday. Much of it showing on the model has gone from England and Wales, but there will be pockets across the higher tops where freezing conditions still stay in existence. So just be aware of that on the higher mountains of England and Wales. Some icy conditions may still be around in places. And to end the week, that's where the model thinks things have got to by Friday, and notably still a good covering of snow across much of the Highlands. So that's still going to be around even if temperatures are rising. Here's Saturday's synoptic chart, and high pressure is strongly centred to the east of us, but fronts are just nibbling away from the Atlantic, and that's the gradual change into next week. But for the time being, we're still importing a very cold air mass from the continent. It's all coming round originally from Scandinavia and coming across Britain on a strong southeasterly wind. And that wind, gale or severe gale force across many of the mountains, and some very powerful gusts in places to lower slopes, just roaring down slope to the north of some of the major summits around Snowdon, in places across the Lake District, and particularly around Ben Nevis and the Cairngorms, any of those northern corries, some very powerful gusts indeed. Now the front which lies out towards the west is making some progress in, with some snow turning up across Wales. Largely a dry day elsewhere, with just some high-level cloud obscuring the sunshine. a degree of uncertainty in the progress of the snow in the west. This is just to take things on hour by hour from the modelling. It does bring the snow into Wales through the afternoon as that front runs into the cold air. There's not much change of temperature at this point, and some snow flurries just turning up across the westernmost mountains in Scotland as we head onwards later in the afternoon. Otherwise, not amounting to a great deal, and that front itself, actually, as it comes in through Saturday evening, more or less just fizzles out as it pushes further eastwards. We do get the next push of fronts though coming in as we go into the early hours of Sunday and Sunday daytime with the next areas of snow, and then becoming an awkward mix really, with some snow, some freezing rain in places, and more for Wales eventually turning more generally to rain as that milder air does edge in. But elsewhere it's going to be that rather tricky wintry and icy mix well on through Sunday daytime. Some places could see that rather persistent over a good many hours. Locally, to the north of major hill groups, especially northern Scotland, you may see very little of that at all. But a messy day in terms of cloud, likely to shroud many of the higher hills. It's another very windy one as well through Sunday. Severe gale force winds across many mountains through the day. Still a severe chill factor then in exposure to that wind. The temperature though quite variable, really ranging between as low as say -5 and some places maybe to freezing point or just above as the milder air just starts to filter its way in from the Atlantic. Now, by the time we get to Monday, those fronts have pushed further east and northeastwards across Britain, so we've sort of changed the weather regime from where we've been in recent days. It's coming in on a south to southwesterly. It's not looking quite as windy as it was over the weekend, but still a blustery picture for many of the mountains. Temperatures are comparatively higher for many places, but those local variations in freezing level likely just to occur in places for the highlands. Some areas of showers likely just across west and southwestern facing hills. Maybe fewer of that for Wales, but still bits and pieces of rain may be around at times. Shouldn't amount to a great deal. The odd heavier shower, maybe just around western Scotland, associated with a bit of a trough there. A bit of hail could be just thrown in for good measure locally. Lowest of the cloud towards western coast, best of the breaks for the east and northeast that you go. Detail is tricky, it must be said, by the time we get to Tuesday, but some various fronts are rolling in from the Atlantic, so some areas of precipitation. Now, there might be some snow in amongst this on the higher ground, mainly in Scotland, as those freezing levels just come back down a little bit. Otherwise, most of it falling as rain, as temperatures are above freezing towards higher slopes. It could make things rather icy, though, where there's still some snow in existence and things just refreeze on the surface. Wednesday, still the idea of some fronts being around, maybe not a particularly active system, we need to watch this obviously at this sort of distance, but some precipitation around, largely rain, a bit of snow on the very highest tops perhaps in places. Those fronts may just then break up a little bit as they pass eastwards. So where do things go by the time we get to the later part of next week? It still looks as though the general airflow is a south by southwesterly, at least for a time. Temperatures tending to rise with that airflow. Still, some fronts may just drift past westernmost regions, so some precipitation at times. Indications, though, towards next weekend would suggest that low pressure systems over the Atlantic are sort of held at bay, and higher pressure lying to the east and northeast of us starts to exert a bit more influence. Now, that is drawing up a general airflow out of the Mediterranean, so a southeasterly wind, which, not on the face of it, too different from what we're seeing just at the moment, but it's the source of the air that's critical in terms of the temperatures that we'll see. At the moment, it's being dragged around from Scandinavia, but by next weekend, that idea that it's even coming up from North Africa. So a much milder, indeed, maybe even warm feel to things by the time we get to next weekend in that situation. Alpine conditions across the Scottish mountains is perhaps a good description. Some inversion state conditions in place. Now, that will allow some overnight refreezing and then some daytime thawing. So the snowpack that's in existence across the higher eastern half of the Scottish Highlands still going to stay in place for quite a while, even if the temperatures do indeed rise markedly. It could be a generally drier story by this point, as we're just holding off any Atlantic fronts and higher pressure is near to us. What we need to look for in the longer range, and it's maybe just tentative at this stage, is if that high does get back further north into Scandinavia, we might just open the door to another almost final fling of winter if the wind flow turns back round more to the east. Now that's very cautious because it's more than 10 days away, but just one or two suggestions to going along the lines of turning that wind flow back as an east by southeasterly, which could just bring those temperatures back down again. But I think before that happens, you can expect a more spring-like feel to things later next week. You can stay up to date with all those developments, of course, every day on our website and through the NWIS YouTube channel as well. Thanks for watching this video today. That's been your Friday Planner in association with Ellis Brigham. Bye for now.